Let's get past this. For my first time ever, I'm going to paint a wall. Well, as a blind person, I've always kind of thought maybe I could do some painting. I could cover a wall with paint. I mean, how hard could it be? We're out here in the garage and we've sectioned off an 8 foot by 8 foot piece of the wall. This way I can try painting, and it'd be like painting perhaps like a small bedroom, one wall of a small bedroom. I've got a roller. I have a paint tray. And of course I have a gallon of red paint, which I'm gonna cover the wall with. I've never done anything like this before. I painted with a brush to try and paint a box. I figured we'd try something small first. So that's about all I know about painting. Other than that, maybe some finger painting in school. The box was messy. There was a lot of excess. There was a lot of extra paint on the box. So that's one thing I don't want to do today. I want to be nice and even and, you know, not have to have some sanding afterwards to get all the paint off. I practiced by doing some work with the empty roller, with a dry paint roller, just to feel it on the wall and to feel how it moves up and down and to get used to my arms moving and my body and stuff. Putting the roller in the paint tray and then taking it back over to the wall and make-believe paint and just trying to do it. Because otherwise I would have no idea what I'm doing. I feel like I could get probably about 3/4 of it covered. Certainly more than half. I'll say 3/4 is best case. No, I can get 3/4. Okay, you ready? All right. Okay, so just like that.
Now that wasn't at all the trick.
Oh, that wasn't, okay. Can I reach down and touch too? Yes, okay, here we go. Inside, like that. A little nerve-wracking. Some of the challenges, I think, is getting the paint from the roller out of the tray onto the wall without dripping it all over myself and keeping straight lines up and down. I think that's gonna be a big challenge for me because I've never been good at that. Let's see. Right there, okay. Right now I'm having a look to see how much I've done and just sort of get a feel for the coverage. The frustrating part is to, you know, have it so far from my hands. To make this an extension of my arms is very tricky for me. That's one of the things I'm finding the most difficult right now. Now I'd like to see, just for fun here. Wow. Okay, that needs some. Okay. With the sound I'm hearing, I can tell whether or not the roller is flush with the wall, right? That I'm making full contact, because there's no sort of scraping or anything if other parts of the cage touch the wall. It's a pure roller on the wall. See, that wasn't. I feel like I've done pretty much the whole thing up and down. I don't feel like I've missed anything. Honestly, I don't. I think some places might be a little thicker than others, but I think I have the whole wall fairly covered. Confidently, I can say that. I feel good. I'm sweating. It's 100 degrees now. I mean, the pressure has also made me a bit nervous. I put a lot of pressure on myself for this job. One of the mishaps was I painted the guides along the edges of the wall here, the top and bottom. I'm sure there's paint all over the 2x4s that were meant to be a boundary. So that's kind of messy too. Oh, I went too far. There were a couple times where I went completely outside the boundary. I knocked the roller over at the very beginning, which was great, knocked it right into the paint. But that's it. Thank you. for my first time, what kind of a grade would you give me? If you were a teacher, what would you say?
I'd give you a B. No question. You covered a lot of the area. We need to get a fixer in there fast to sort of smooth it out.
Yep.
So it's gonna cost us another guy. But that would just come out of your paycheck.
Oh, that's fine, listen, I don't mind.
Hey, this is how we learn.
Pay it forward, that's right, this is how you learn, baby.